problem you have is time. It is already, we're hitting October soon.
Exactly. Pero yung sa rice price cap, Ms. Karen, good news is there were already recommendations from CNAG and the Farmers Group to baka pwedeng kansilahin. And what I have been hearing from Malacanang, the president may suspend it hopefully by the end of the month or around October. Pag pumasok na ito mga newly harvested na palay, eh, syempre bababa na yan because we have enough or ample of supply of rice. So bababa na itong presyo. So aalisin na yung rice price cap. Then. And yun naman talaga ang objective of Malacanang. Lagyan ng price cap lang ngayon habang taghirap ng bigas. Pero ang talaga ang target nila towards the end of the month or around first or second week of October, aalisin na yung rice price cap na yan, Ms. Karen.
Okay. Now, moving on to rice a bit, will there be a redefinition of the NFA? The reason I'm asking is the primary responsibility of the NFA today is just to buffer stock, right? And the president announced a different pricing scheme for the NFA when it purchases rice. Nung panahon natin, Congressman Irwin, as when you were a reporter, we remember that the NFA was also selling rice. I mean, of course, there were corruption issues with the NFA because it was importing rice as well. But you would see rice noon that was 27 pesos in the market, right? Different quality, but then still you'd have rice that it was subsidized, I remember, by 7 pesos. So yung 26, 7 pesos ang subsidy ng gobyerno doon. Is there a recommendation from the speaker how we can maximize what to do with the NFA?
Yung we have to review the rice liberalization or rice tariffication law kasi nakapaloob yun doon para to allow if we have to junk this rice tariffication law or rice liberalization law, if we have to junk it, then we have to replace with something, then we will give power. Pinag-uusapan na, Ms. Karen, is on the table with the Committee on Agriculture headed by Congressman Enverga and the Speaker and other House leadership. Kung ano ang gagawin to giving back the power of NFA to purchase palay and then the NFA will sell the rice, mill it, and sell it to the public para we can control. I believe we're heading towards that direction, yeah. Starting.
Because the problem of the NFA before, and you remember this, Congressman Tulfo, was the head was corrupt. There was systemic corruption issues in the NFA. But if you change the system and the head, right? If you had like a Lacson on NFA or whoever that was anti-corruption, then it could maybe function better.
It was also discussed, Ms. Karen, if we have to go back to the old ways, na NFA will purchase palay directly to the farmers or from the farmers, then we have to put somebody there na capable and medyo diretso ang tingin, hindi kung saan-saan, at saka hindi corrupt. I believe we can really fix this problem, Ms. Karen. Talaga kailangan lang natin. For now, if you will ask me, not only me, but even the Makaya Bayan Bloc and other fellow congressmen there, it's really high time now. We really have to review this oil, this rice tariffication law or rice liberalization law, Ms. Karen.
Okay. All right. Now, another issue here is the Makabayan Bloc. Let's go back now to the issue of oil. The Makabayan Bloc blames actually the government on something simple. Budget mismanagement, the president's foreign trips, the confidential funds for certain agencies, instead of spending it for the right things.
Okay. And the question
is, that being one of them, possibly, right?
Well, my point naman, Ms. Karen, I mean, the Makabayan Bloc has a point, and trabaho naman talaga nila yon to always check, parang may checks and balances. We do embrace that. Tama naman yung ginagawa ng Makabayan Bloc to really check. Meron tayong ika nga bastonero or something. Pero I believe kami sa majority, we really have to study further these issues kasi medyo critical siya eh. At saka ang daming mga issue na dapat uusapan, dapat ayusin. Kung maiimbestigan naman tayo sa mga confidential intelligence funds, yung mga expenses of travel by the president, why don't we just focus on something like come up, like ginagawa po natin yesterday, talking to oil price or oil companies, talking next week, may plano si speaker, nakausapin yung mga food manufacturers, canned goods, supermarkets, kung pwedeng i-hold off muna because they are asking DTI now, this group of business people, na tataas din sila. Pero unfortunately, it's almost Christmas season, Ms. Karen. E pag tinaasan mo yung mga canned goods, what is going to happen? I mean, we will have a very bleak Christmas, Ms. Karen. So ito yung dapat unahin ng siguro ng Kongreso, ng Senado. How can we address the problem of the people? Pag kumakalam kasi ang sikmura, Ms. Karen, hindi ka nakakaisip ng tama. So we have to address this muna, these issues, rather than investigating itong budget papunta roon, saan ang nanggaling, di ba? It's more helpful if we find solution to the current problem, Ms. Karen.
Yeah. So just to be specific, since the numbers were given out what it would cost the government if excise tax was removed and if they can import bioethanol. I'm curious, do you have a calculation of just how much private companies can cut? What sacrifice can they make? Is there already a number with that? I mean, do you already have the number on the profit per liter of oil companies?
Doon sa usapan lang namin sa Congress, kami yung mga House leadership na pag-usapan, kaya nila hanggang 5 pesos, Ms. Karen. Eh. 5
really?
To 10, 10 talagang
really?
Sacrifice. Yes.
Kaya that's nila 5 pesos na wala pa tong government intervention.
That's what we were just waiting, Mr. Karen. But we, of course, we cannot dictate it because of this all the regulation law. Pero we were looking, according to our economic managers then, sila Congressman Salceda, sila Congresswoman Kiambao, kakayanin eh sila Congressman Saldico, kakayanin eh hanggang 5 pesos eh. They at saka yung downgradation na sinasabi, you import early kasi when you import for December, you import now or you ask them now, place your order now, mababa, Ms. Karen, why don't they do that? Bakit hindi na sila way ahead mag-order na for December para lalong bumaba? Kasi parang bumababa ng something like about $10 per barrel pag nag-import ka very early on.
Oo. But then clearly there's a bigger issue here in terms of the country's future, right? We are an importing country when it comes to oil. You have factors that are outside. So for example, in the report, there were production curbs set by Russia and Saudi Arabia. You have forex issues, world prices issues. There has to be a systemic change.
Yeah, I believe so, Ms. Karen.
And what do we do?
It should be a constant study and meeting by the economic managers, by several groups, Congress, Senate, the executive, to come up with a plan or better idea, clearer idea on what do we have to do. Kasi ito mga solutions right now that we're coming up, these are band-aid solutions. We want a long-term solution for everybody, Ms. Karen. Yeah. So we really need to put our heads together para to come up with something. Siguro all the stakeholders, hindi lang government, kundi pati yung mga private sector, motorists, oil companies, yung mga consumers. We really have parang a dialogue of what do we have to do? Because, Ms. Karen, if you really look at it, parang itong country natin, we're living under one roof, okay? We're having a hard time. I mean, the padre de familia is having a hard time to feed the family because of this blah, 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 budget cuts or whatever, high prices. So we really have to get the inputs of everybody, Ms. Karen. I believe that's what we should do.
All right. Just two more questions for you. That's quite interesting. It's up to you how you want to answer it. There are talks that you might be the running mate of Speaker Martin Romualdez if he chooses to run for president. You're the VP. Is that true? Is it on the table?
No, not at all. Not at all, Ms. Karen. I'm just helping. I am a deputy majority leader for communications. That's why I am talking to you. That's why I entertain when the media would call somebody. Mr. Speaker designated me to be the spokesperson of Congress. So
no VP plans for you?
No, Ms. Karen. That's very, very, way, way off, Ms. Karen. Way off.
No. All right. Okay. My last question is, the Speaker won't answer this, but there's talk of a $2 million donation to Harvard University. I mean, I don't know if you're allowed to speak on that, but why won't he answer it if it's a donation to push actually, it pushed the Filipino language globally. It's something that he could actually be proud of and speak of. Why won't he answer these questions?
True enough, Ms. Karen. It's a personal, that's from his own pocket. And marami, lalo ng mga Tigalete, alam naman talaga na mayayaman ng mga Romualdes, they can afford that. Pero yung not answering it, Ms. Karen, because I already asked the speaker yesterday morning about it. I said, like, Mr. Speaker, marami po nagtatanong. He said, like, instead na mag-focus tayo dyan kung Erwin, why don't we just focus, look for a solution dito sa problema ng sambayanan? Okay, sasagutin ko nga yan, pero ma-address ba natin yung problem ng bayan ngayon? Pero kung ako ang tatanungin mo, Ms. Karen, kung milyonaryo ka man, 2 million dollars is about 100 million pesos, eh kung yun ay personal naman niya talaga, eh pera naman ta, pera niya, and I believe it is, so I mean, why not, di ba? Marami siya mga kaibigan doon, mga ika nga, sa Congress, marami ako nakikita ng mga kaklase niya dati na nag-masteral sa Harvard, so medyo malapit din sa kanya sa puso yung Harvard na ito. Pero yun na, kaya hindi niya sinasagot, Ms. Karen, because mas maraming problema na dapat isikasuhin daw na we have to devote time on how to solve this problem. Itong oil prices, food prices, ito yung mga dapat unahin, Ms. Karen.
Okay, so my last question, back to the oil price. Do you have a timetable? I mean, clearly there's pressure here. It's a crisis situation. Meron ba itong sa isang linggo, dalawang linggo, dapat, Karen, eto sabi ni Speaker, bababa ang presyo ng langis. May ganun na ba kayong napag-usapan, sir?
We are waiting for the response from the oil companies, yung kanilang mga principals, mga chairman of the board nila, because they were asking, yung mga managers yesterday were asking, like, give us about a week, Mr. Speaker, we'll come back, so we will be meeting them again. So we're expecting, like, around probably, hopefully, end of September, Ms. Karen, we have a result already, or at least the very latest will be like around first week or second week of October, we can do something about it. Because we also have to lay down to the president and at the options, Ms. Karen, the plans of our Congress, suggestions.
All right. Okay. Well said. Thank you so much. So most likely, first week of October, definitely there's some change, right? There's action. Okay. On that note, I want to thank you, Congressman Erwin Tulfo, for joining me today. Thank you, sir.
Thank you, ma'am, for the time again. You have a wonderful day.